and welcome to this series of three webinars, which will show you how to use the different AutoChartist features. SwiftCoat has been collaborating with AutoChartist for over 5 years. Our common goal is to make life easier for the trader. How? Facilitating the search for technical analysis patterns directly on the charts and providing you with a wealth of information on the value of different technical analysis patterns, as well as significant statistical data. SwiftCoat offers the AutoChartist plugin free of charge to its customers. You can install it on your MetaTrader 4 or 5 platform to integrate its technical analysis tools directly on the charts. How to do it? It's simple. Visit our website, swiftcoat.com, click on Forex on the navigation bar, then Platform, and select AutoChartist. Scrolling down, you can proceed with the installation. First, you need to have SwiftCoat MetaTrader already installed on your computer. If not, please begin with step number one. If you are already our customer, start with step number two, where you also find the user guide made available to you. Please follow the set of instructions from the step number three. If you need more information about our services and how to trade with Forex and CFDs, don't hesitate to contact us. I now leave the floor to Ilan Asbel, CEO and founder of AutoChartist. I hope you can benefit from all the insights he will provide. Please take some time to read our disclaimer. After this, you can find more videos visiting swiftcoat.com/webinars.
Hi, this is Ilan Asbel, CEO at AutoChartist. Welcome to today's webinar. It's going to be a very brief overview of AutoChartist and what it does for you as a trader. So I want to dive right in. The first thing that you know that every trader asks is, how's this tool going to help me become a better trader, right? And this tool is focused on four primary things. Right? It is what to trade. It helps you figure out what there is to trade, when to trade it. When to potentially close a position, and how much money to risk on the trade, right? And in today's overview, I'm just going to, literally it is an overview, and then in subsequent webinars, I'm going to show you how to actually use some of the stuff in real live scenarios, right? How to actually use it in your trading platform. So in terms of what to trade and when, right? So AutoChartist primarily identifies three major classifications of trade setups. So I want to talk about the first two chart patterns and horizontal levels within the context of breakout or trend trading versus mean reversion trading. Right, and so I might be talking a bit of kind of gibberish to you right now, but hopefully by the end of this webinar, you'll understand. So you can see on my screen at the moment that we have two examples, one on EURUSD, one on AMX, it's a stock on the New York Stock Exchange. These are just for illustration purposes. So you can see here that the euro was trending in a very strong upward trend, and then there was a breakout, right? And because of that breakout, AutoChartist believes that the price is going to go down towards this red line of this red area over here, which we call that the forecast region. Okay, this is what we call a breakout trading opportunity. And here's the word breakout. The same thing can happen for horizontal patterns, right? So this was here was a chart pattern. Chart patterns, remember, are based on two things. There's a resistance level and a support level, whereas horizontal patterns are based on only one thing, either support or resistance. As in this case, this is the resistance level. And you can see that the price of AMX has consolidated here and here, and now finally it consolidated and then broke through that level. And now we provide a forecast up to 1656. Okay, again, this is a breakout horizontal level, right? So it's broken through the horizontal level. Now, many people on the market, they've heard things like the trend is your friend, right? These type of people that like to repeat that that lingo or that phrase, the trend is your friend. These are the kind of traders that trade these kind of breakout opportunities, right? They believe that there's going to be a new trend in the market. Here in euro dollar, it was trending up. Now, because of the breakout, we feel that the trend is going to change. Here, AMX was kind of moving sideways, but now there was a breakout and we feel the trend is going to start moving upwards, right? So what you're trying to do there is you're trying to pick up on the trend. And obviously, that's where the word comes from. The trend is your friend. However, the next kind of trading opportunities that Autochart brings up in the field of chart patterns and horizontal levels are what we call emerging patterns, right? Now, emerging patterns are a little different in that they are emerging. They have not yet broken through, right? So you can see in this situation, this is a share called A on the New York Stock Exchange. There was a very definitive resistance level, a support level, but the price has not yet broken through on the upside or the downside, right? It's still trading in this upward trajectory, right? So in this situation, obviously, we don't provide a target region like we did in this example above it, right? But we do give you a warning, right, that there is something going on A, and potentially there could be an upside breakout or a downside breakout. If you're a very, very short-term high-risk trader, you could, in fact, take a very short-term long position up to this resistance level, or potentially even some kind of sell limit, right, where you would wait until the price gets to that level and then trade short, thinking it's going to bounce off it. This is what we call mean reversion trading. And the same thing in this example on GBPNZD, this is a horizontal level, right, so it's only made up of one line, not both support resistance, but in this case, just a support line. And you can see that Autochart did a good thing in identifying this pattern. It consolidated here and here and here, and there was a breakout, and now it's moving back towards this level. Again, no breakout yet, and a number of different ways to potentially trade this. Either you can trade a very short-term short position down to this level, or you can wait until this price breaks that level and go short using, for example, let's say a sell stop, or you could wait until this price touches and then go long, assuming it's going to rebound. You know, that would be something like a buy limit trade, right? So a number of different ways to trade this. The one thing I have to say is that these emerging type of scenarios, that is not the emerging scenario. Let me clear that. I made a mistake. These emerging scenarios over here, they are, you know, certainly for the more experienced traders, right? People that are watching their screens a lot more frequently, keeping in touch with the markets. If you're a kind of person that only goes to your trading screen, you know, once every few hours or once a day, this is potentially not the kind of trading opportunities you need to look for. So I mentioned the word before, trend traders. Trend traders are the ones that trade those things on top. I'll put a T for trend. And the ones at the bottom, these are normally traded by what they call swing traders. Swing as in they swing between overbought and oversold prices, right? And that's really the foundation of everything that Autochart does, right? It tries to identify these overbought and oversold levels. You can see it over here. At this price, the market thought that euro was too expensive, and so it went down. At this price here, it thought it was too cheap and started going up. Or here, it thought it was too expensive and started going down. Similarly, it was too cheap, right? This is the same thing that you see all the time, again and again in financial markets, right? This fluctuation between overbought and oversold, too expensive, too cheap, too expensive, too cheap, right? It's all about market psychology. And that's really the thing that Autochart tries to identify, is these fluctuations in this market psychology. The other two types of trading opportunities that I want to discuss at Autochart is, the first one is called large movements. That is where Autochart identifies an exceptionally large movement for that instrument. So in this example here, it's a Euro CAD. and there was a very, very big movement, you know, from 156.60 down to looks like a 156, a 151.60, and a very big movement. In fact, from a statistical perspective, this is what we call a movement in the 98th percentile. That means 98% of movements on EuroCAD are smaller than this one, right? So this is an exceptionally large short movement, and now we potentially either expect the price to move back, right? Because it's moved too much in one direction. Or if it breaks previous support levels, then we expect it to move down. In this situation, the price had enough and ran out of steam and started moving back up again, right? The second type of movement that we identify is what we call consecutive candles. It's kind of similar to large movements, is that normally it represents an exceptionally large movement, but the identification is not around the size of the movement, but rather around the number of consecutive bullish or bearish candles. And in this example, you can see that there was 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 consecutive bullish candles. Again, do we think there can be another bullish candle? Maybe, but certainly because it was identified as a consecutive candles trade setup on order charters, it means that 98% or 7 consecutive bullish candles is greater than 98% of all other consecutive moving candles found on this instrument, right, on LEG. Okay, so these are the kind of trade setups that AutoCharters identifies. There is one other type, which is the Fibonacci patterns. I am not a Fibonacci trader. If you are, it means you're very advanced and you're probably not listening to my presentation here today. I'm not a believer in Fibonacci patterns because I believe if you draw enough lines, you know, you're going to hit something. But don't let me stop you from trading Fibonacci patterns. You know, I know some very successful traders that do use Fibonacci to trade, just not my personal favorite thing to do. And I don't like to talk about things I don't really understand. And I hope you appreciate that. So that is how AutoChartist really helps you to identify trading opportunities in terms of what and when to trade. And in the next few webinars, we're actually going to show you some of these opportunities in your trading platform that actually send you signals to show you, to give you that market timing. Now, the next thing that I want to show you in AutoChartist is really around market volatility and how to set what I call market appropriate stop loss positions, right? So if I look at, let's say in this example, I'm looking at the Australian dollar, right? Now, this is a graph of the volatility of Australian dollar across a 24-hour period. I believe this is probably at a GMT or GMT plus 2. I'm not sure exactly. And you can see very clearly that at 1 a.m., 2 a.m., the price of Australian dollar is very, very volatile, right? It moves a lot, up to 24 pips in an hour. When London opens, again, 7 a.m., very volatile, up to 20 to 20, 22 pips, 23 pips in an hour. At 9 a.m. when New York opens, again, very volatile. And then the volatility decreases. And then again, volatile looks like maybe when the Australian markets open, right? And so one needs to keep in mind this different amount of volatility for different times of day, because so often I see traders setting the same stop levels and trading the same position sizes at different times of the day, right? And that's just wrong, bottom line wrong. You need to adjust your position sizing and your stop loss and take profit levels according to the present market volatility, okay? And so if you're not doing that, then you could just give yourself a disadvantage. For example, let's look at an example. If I was trading Australian dollar, US dollar at this very most volatile time of day, okay, and we know that it's going to trade between, looks like 15 pips and 25 pips within 1 hour. Now, what if my normal trading strategy uses a 10 pip stop, loss, okay? I'm going to be in my position for maybe 5 minutes or 10 minutes. I'm going to get stopped out by noise. And that's something you don't want to happen. You don't want to get stopped out for market noise. You want to get stopped out because you actually made the wrong projection, not because of market noise, right? And then so often, I'm sure it's happened to you, you've taken a position, you know, it's hit your stop level, your position's closed out, and then next thing, it just skyrockets back in the direction you initially forecast. That, you know, a lot of traders go to their broker and say, hey, you're chasing my stop losses. That's just all nonsense, okay? The broker does not need your trade. He's got tons of other positions going the other way on the same instrument. Blaming the broker for that is total nonsense. You need to blame yourself. People just don't like blaming themselves. They don't understand market volatility, and so they end up trying to find who was at fault and why the position was closed out. So you need to try and educate yourself around when the instruments that you trade are volatile. Now, in some of the trading platforms you support, you will notice that AutoCharts provides what we call the trumpet, or the volatility analysis trumpet. And that's in the form of these horizontal levels that show you where the expected volatility is for 1 hour, 4 hours, and 24 hours, right? So you can see here on this AUD USD example, this is a 60-minute chart, we think that this is where the 1 hour volatility is going to be. This is where the 4 hour volatility is going to be and the 24 hour volatility is going to be, right? So if you're planning to take a position now on AUD on the Australian dollar and you want to go drop the kids off and that's going to take you an hour, chances are you shouldn't be setting your stop loss within this range, okay? Because by the time you get back from dropping your kids off at school, your position is going to be closed and you won't have any control over what's going on, right? So you need to set your stop losses outside of that 1 hour range, okay? Because then you have a chance to come back from dropping your kids at school and actually mess around with your stop loss and take profit positions to figure out what's going on in the market. Similarly, now, if you don't want to incur swap costs or earn swap on your position, then you shouldn't be setting your take profit and stop loss outside of the daily highs and lows, okay? Because then it means that you're going to be holding your position for a really, really long time. You're using up margin. Are you giving up other potential trading opportunities because you don't have enough margin to trade those others, right? You need to make sure that you know that when you're trading, when you're opening a position, you're using up margin in your account, and that limits you in terms of how many other positions you can take in the market at the same time. So holding positions for a very long time certainly doesn't work very well in OTC and highly leveraged environments such as FX or CFDs or anything like that, right? So again, AutoChartist helps you to show you where the market volatility is to be expected. And so in the next few webinars, we're going to go into real live market examples to show you how these trading opportunities, these trade setups, and how this volatility analysis and risk management comes into play at AutoChartist. And I hope to see you again soon. Thank you for your attention. Have a nice one. Bye.